I am so sorry. They're the words a courtroom has heard from a dramatic 000 call made by a daycare driver moments after he found the lifeless body of a three-year-old boy in his bus.
Two people are charged over his death, and in a shocking twist, police are now investigating if the childcare centre doctored the boy's attendance record.
Father of three, daycare manager and bus driver Michael Glenn Lewis, free on bail, charged with manslaughter over the death of a three-year-old boy in his care. Michael, you are the manager. How was this allowed to happen?
There's no comment on matters before the court.
Also charged and bailed, daycare worker Dione Beatrice Grills for the role she allegedly played in leaving the boy on the bus.
Dione, there are a lot of questions about what happened that day. Can you provide any answers to the family at all?
Her position as an employee of Good Start Early Learning puts an element of responsibility upon her.
In a bail hearing, the court heard, before 7.30, the daycare minibus made a morning run to collect other children. Just before 9, the boy's mother phoned to say she'd like her son taken to daycare too. At 9.15, Lewis and Grills picked the boy up from his home. CCTV showing them exiting the bus 18 minutes later at the centre without the boy. Lewis then drove the bus to a meeting nearby. Over the next 4.5 hours, outside temperatures soared to 35 degrees. After returning to the centre, Lewis discovered the boy's body just before the afternoon run home. The child was just two seats behind the driver.
What would you say to the boy's family? Would you like to say anything to the boy's family?
The court read a transcript of Lewis's 000 call. Oh my God, this kid is dead. I've left a child on the bus all day. I am so sorry. Oh my God, I'm going to jail. Oh my God, my whole life is over.
The court heard the boy was fraudulently signed in to his centre's electronic attendance system 2 hours before his bus arrived. A possible practice, investigators say, to ensure the boy's family didn't lose their childcare benefit payments.
For the boy's family in court, yet to be explained, how did two trained childcare workers not see him on the bus?
How's the family feeling? Obviously a tough time for you guys.
Very.
The court also heard more shocking evidence that neither of the childcare workers used the regular paper system to sign the boy on or off the bus. Good Start Early Learning, which owns and runs the childcare centre, has now stood the pair down. While they are now free to walk the streets, despite all the evidence, all the revelations that we heard today, Melissa, that big question still remains tonight. Why was the boy left on the bus?